A typical Bollywood film would have songs in it. So it's really a musical experience, and it's almost like going to the theater to see a play.
Any emotion you have, you'll have a song attached to that.
Yeah. It has different moments, like tragedy moments, happy moments, and it has loads of dances. Normally ends in a happy way.
There's always some type of wedding in a Bollywood movie. There's always someone who dies in a Bollywood movie.
Probably like girl meets boy, boy can't be with girl, girl's father approves.
Yeah, parents
disapprove.
There are also loads of love triangles and complications, and then there's loads of affairs on the side.
There's also very overdramatic acting, like the person will slap the sun and the sun will fly from this wall to the other wall. Just very overdramatic, but it's colourful and fun.
There's always a romantic song based in some sort of nature, like a field or a beach or a mountain
or
the pyramids.
My English friend wanted to see what Bollywood was, so she watched Gobbly Kushy Gobbly Gum, and she was like, "Nishi, why are they transporting from different destinations in their love song?" I was like, "You know what? It's Bollywood, don't question it."
I think for Bollywood to the outside world, well, to maybe like non-Asians, I think it would be a lot about the colour, the bindis, the songs. I don't think they really fully understand sort of like there are storylines behind it. They think it's all very colourful and bright and dances and singing and all this stuff, and it's very like theatrical. But there are some that have deep stories in them, like My Name is Khan and stuff.
My Name is Khan, it's a lot more Western, so you can relate. Well, we could relate to it more because it's
set in America,
and America is quite similar to England, and it shows how well, it's true. I mean, when people see Asian people, they do assume Muslim. I mean, that's what I usually get a lot.
At the airport?
At the airport. And you know, people often assume Muslims with terrorism. And my name is Khan, like, addresses this issue. And it shows just, like, not everyone who's a Muslim, not everyone that's brown, not everyone that's an Asian is a terrorist. And I think Love No One is one of the strong ones.
The thing I like about Bollywood movies, I think, is the high drama, the music, of course, the music is fantastic, the dancing, but also the language. The Hindi language is very beautiful. It's melodic. So putting the music with the language, I think, is a very beautiful thing to do. But the language itself is a very poetic language.
And it's like music from your own culture. You feel like
it's connected.
Even though you don't know what it means, you feel like
connected.
It's so true.
Yeah, exactly. Chakadana, bi chakadana, dane upar dana, hi chakadana. Chakye upar larki nache larka hai diwana, hi chakadana.
I like Bollywood dance because the moves sometimes are quite like easy to repeat, and they're quite catchy, the songs, so it makes you wanna like dance to them. So I remember when I was younger, and I used to watch Indian movies, and whenever the dance came on, I used to pretend I was the girl dancing in the movie.
You can just like picture yourself being in the movie, and I just think that's very cool.
You feel that you've been born and bred to like be able to do it. Like at a wedding, you're expected to know how to do it. It's like not like hip hop or something where you do it and you're like, oh no, I'm not good at this because I'm Asian or something like that.
With my culture, and also it's a lot more free than other types of dances. Like when you go back there, you know that you're a part of the community and you still do things that they do.
I connect to Bollywood because it's obviously because being brought up in England and having different kinds of multicultural friend, it reminds me about my culture and what I believe in and my background. It's a reminder of where I'm from.
obviously it's in India and you don't live in India, you live in England, and you see how things are out there, you see it just influences you, like the fashion, like you know what they're wearing out there, so you want to wear it here if you've ever gotten Asian event.
Because they don't get the gist of Indian culture. They just see this showpiece. All people are wearing nice clothes, wearing this, wearing that, jewelry and big weddings and all these things. This is what is happening in this society, in British society as well. Nowadays, I can see, I've been to some weddings and I saw there, in one wedding I went recently, there was this priest who did all the, who wanted to do all the rituals of Indian wedding, but through Bollywood songs. No mantra, nothing, but every ritual got a related Bollywood song put in there. And we were thinking, what? Is this the wedding or is this the Bollywood film we are watching? But the younger generation liked it.
But growing up in this country, there was very little that connected me to my own, my country of origin. All we really had was the family, the religion, you know, when I went to the mosque. And even then, most of it was in Arabic, and I didn't understand Arabic. I could read it, couldn't understand it. And then there were the movies, which I did understand. So inevitably, it does have an impact upon you and upon your life. Maybe your expectations are different. Your life expectations are different. You want that big romance. You want the, you want your life to be that much more grander, that much more over the top. You want a rags to riches story. Maybe these things sort of seep into your subconscious, and that's what you're somehow hoping for.
Bollywood film has got escapism, and because it's, you know, people are all the times working hard, they don't get so many things, and people find that watching that film.
Generally speaking, Bollywood is such high drama, almost like the Greek tragedies used to be. And so these are big stories on a grand sort of scale. And to put that with music and with singing and with dancing, and then they have the best singers in the country that are singing, and they have the best actors with the best dancers who are dancing the stuff, and then they put it all together into one artistic vision. That's, who isn't going to like that?
We are fan of Bollywood.
I love watching Umra Jaan again and again and again, for the dances and for the lyrics, for the subject and for the acting, and even the end. Even though we know what's going to happen at the end, every time when the end comes, I feel like crying.
Bollywood films had always played on people's emotions. They are very emotional films, they are very touchy films, and we used to cry in them. when I watched that Amar Prem, I started crying in the film. And you know, that was the fun of it, really, which you don't get it in English films.
You know, at the ending, I used to think that he actually died. We established that I was a bit obsessed with him. So my dad was like, Nishi, why are you crying? And I was like, he's dead.
I started crying when the grandma died. Yes. And they were all together and they all put the hand in the thing. And I was like, oh.
I cried when Amitabh Bachchan stabbed Sharukh Khan.
Oh my god, I cried at that point. Because I just thought that would really hurt.
No, I cried in the bench scene. When Shah Rukh saying goodbye to his little brother, and I was like,
I didn't cry.
You guys, it was such an intimate sibling moment. It was just really sad.
But my favourite film is Lagan, because I just like the way they portrayed it and just everything it tells you and the songs and just everything I just love about it.
The music is fantastic. I think the music's by A.R. Rahman. The acting by Amir Khan was just wonderful. It was his first movie that he produced as well.
Early 1900s, I think, but just before they got their independence. I like it because it shows like the villages, how it was. I can imagine India being like that. I can imagine the British rule like that.
I think it might have been the first movie, the Indian movie, that was number one in the box office here.
And I just think it's more classic than the ones we see now, and it really represents
Bollywood is, I interpret it, so I love it.
In the dance wise, I liked Guide. The Guide was absolutely, Vaidya Rehman was outstanding. Her Nag dance, I never thought she would dance like that. It was absolutely amazing.
Purely because I think she's very natural and there's less of makeup and less of clothing. The emphasis is more on her acting.
My favorite actress of all time has to be Sri Devi. This woman could act, she could dance, she could do comedy, anything. She could do high drama. She was just amazing at everything. No doubt, Sri Devi was just a queen.
I used to love Rajendra Kumar. He was the sad hero. He used to cry on the tent, on the, you know, in the films. But that was a phase. It went away. And then I started liking Manoj Kumar, which was that time, the 60s or 70s. He was very favorite, very upcoming star. So it went into phases. And then we used to like Jumping Jack, Jitendra Kumar, he used to dance very fast. So that's what we liked about that. And then gradually it sort of fizzled out, all these three heroes gone, and Rajesh Khanna became my last favorite one, absolutely. I watched all the films, most of the films.
My favorite actor is Ranbir Kapoor because I think he's really hot and like Rocky Chasman's gonna look like that. And also, he plays in some of my favorite movies like Ye Jawani Hai Diwani. And I think, you know, he's a really good breakthrough actor.
My favourite, well, I think he was my favourite actor, was Shah Rukh Khan. So he's quite, you know, well known. And I think I liked the characters he played more than him because I don't really know about his personality. But like all of my favourite movies seem to feature him in it. So yeah, he was my favourite.
Then entertainment wise, I can say Sholay was the best film I have ever seen then. Everything, it was a masala film, everything was there. The story there, the hero there. And it took you, it entertained you really well.
Sometimes 1969 or 70, well, I don't remember exact year, but I was in Scotland that time. And Rajesh Khanna's Aradhana, I watched that film with my friends, and all our husbands were teasing us that we were not looking after them, and we were very, very eager to see Rajesh Khanna there. We liked the story, we liked the music, and the beautiful songs which we can still remember, and we still want to hear them again and again.
Roop tera mastana, yaar mera diwana, mil gayi mujhse na ho jaye.
तेरा मस्ताना प्यार मेरा दीवाना भूल कोई हमसे ना हो जाए.
The first time when we saw Sharmila Tagore dressed up in that towel and came out, and we were shocked to see that can happen in Hindi cinema. And I used to adore Rajesh Khanna, absolutely adore. Since from India, I brought that feeling with me. And when I came to this country, I was lost, completely lost, without Indian music, without Indian cinema, without any Indian books, magazines, anything.
The very first one I remember watching is Jolly Jolly, black and white movie, starring Raj Kapoor and Nargis. And the songs in that movie are just fantastic. And so my mum would watch it again and again and again and again. And as I was growing up, I just remember loving this story. And then I remember watching the English version, which is called It Happened One Night. And I just remember thinking, God, this is boring. It's nowhere near as good as the Indian version with all the singing and the dancing. The
first Indian movie that I saw was Kabhi Khushi Kabhi Gham. We saw it at Greenwich Cinemas. I think it was View Cinema. I went with my two daughters.
I remember seeing Hrithik Roshan and saying, I'm going to marry him. He's divorced now.
What a shame.
I remember watching Kareena Kapoor for the first time and liking her in all the like songs.
Because I used to wish I could be her and I could just wear all her outfits. And yeah.
And I still remember the song, Voluturia.
That was my favorite song.
I still want to dance to that song.
We used to go every Sunday in Tooting, but we used to go there, and it was two film they used to stay on Sunday. So Sunday was the special for us because we are all working. So we used to do all work before in weekdays because we want to go to see the film on Sunday. It was Mughlai Azam.
Oh, right, okay.
And it was brilliant film, dance, music, everything, story, everything was nice. When you hear your own language, you won't watch, doesn't matter what time it is, because you miss that one when you come new here.
Well, I remember I went to safari because it was very near to our house, it was in our area. I remember the ladies wore beautiful saris and jewelry, and it came with right from the babies, 4 months, 6 months year old, up to the 12, 13 year old boys and girls like that. As we take all the family with us in India.
During weekdays, mostly we didn't used to wear saris or Punjabi dresses or anything, Indian clothing. But that was the special thing, that our saris came out, we wore nice saris, then we used to sort of think, where did you buy that one? Where did you buy this one? That conversation also went on in the film hall before entering into the film. But that was the one occasion we used to long for, that to go and watch the film, getting dressed up and getting to talk to the people, which we never used to, you know, have chance. Everyday chance was not there. We were stuck in our own small houses and doing all the work and looking after the children, taking the. That was one day we used to come together, have a natter, have a gossip. Really, gossip was the first thing.
I went to see the film Kama Sutra, and actually, the meaning of that one, Kama Sutra, I didn't want it to go. But my husband said, now you will learn more something about that one. And if I said to my friend, we went to see that one, they were laughing at me, that why you want to see that film.
My first film was Dilsat, and I watched it at home when it first came out on DVD. My favourite bit was the train scene. How they danced
on the train, which was very good. The first Bollywood movie I remember seeing was called Chashmi Badoo. It was shown on Channel 4 around about midnight until probably about 6 or 7 in the morning. They'd have all these Bollywood movies running. My parents would video record it, and then we'd sit down the next day and watch it. What I predominantly remember about that movie is the English subtitles. If it hadn't have been for that, I would not have been able to watch it. It's quite fascinating to see because it was very different from what I thought India would be like. As in, most people have never seen a Bollywood movie, they assume that's what Indians are and that's what it's like out in India. Having been to India, totally different. So don't even look at Bollywood movies and think that way.
My first film was Kitch Kitch Our Bird because it came out in 1998 and my grandparents had recorded it on their VCR for me. But I remember watching it and I just loved it, and I always felt sorry for Anjali. And I wanted to look like her with the sweatband and stuff, but it wasn't cool at the time.
The first Bollywood movie I remember watching was probably a Shah Rukh Khan movie because I was a bit in love with him when I was younger. I think it was Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. And I think my favourite part of all Bollywood movies are probably the dances and the songs, and I still enjoy Bollywood movies today.
Yes, Dada Saheb Phalke started recording for these all Marathi films especially. And first there were films without a sound, the Mook Abhinay, they say. And then it started actors and actresses actually talking. And then gradually it started coming in Hindi.
Recently they have made a film about Dada Saheb Phalke, who was the pioneer of cinema in India. And it was called Harishchandrachi Factory, that was made in Marathi. But how he struggled and how he was passionate about the
making films.
He went to watch English films, he went to watch English theatres, he came to England to learn the technique and went back, and he was literally bankrupt.
And when he showed the film, that Raja Harishchandra, and people were really, really enjoyed that film very much, and then they believed, yes, it really can happen.
Bollywood as an industry has definitely changed over the years. When I first started watching Bollywood movies, the filming and location and the storylines were unique to the Indian subcontinent. These days, it is filmed anywhere and everywhere.
Modern films are going away from Indian culture. I don't find any emotional expressions there. Usual masala film, masala dance, masala everything. There is nothing art as such. Masala film is like dance, music, no story. Dancing around, just standing, the dressed up half naked probably, and standing with the hero is doing all the heroism, showing up, and this poor woman follows the hero all the time. She has no opinion, nothing. She just is a fashion icon in that film.
Now what I think the difference between the old Bollywood films and the films of now, that now the films are more realistic. Well, I can remember the films like Lagan or Swadesh or Hina. They have got some subjects that they can touch what problems are going into the society at the moment.
Whatever is happening socially with Indian women are lot of influence of Bollywood's films in real life.
In the 70s, 80s, lots of women were depicted as traditional housewife types or old women, granny types, who would stay at home and just put up with everything. Over the years, it has changed tremendously, as in the characters of the Bollywood women, they've become more glamorous, more risque, especially with the dressing, especially with their sexuality.
Sex symbol, that is what women have become now in Bollywood. No dignity left, no roots to their culture, and they become showpiece and sex symbols.
20, 30 years ago, the Indian actresses then were classically trained dancers from a young age, which then helped them break into the movie scene. These days, a lot of the young actresses start off as models. They've gone from being maybe things like Miss World, Also, we've got the, they're very much into fair complexions. See someone like Katrina Kay. She's just happened to be seen maybe on a catwalk or started off as a model or seen on some advertising board, and somebody thought, oh, she looks good, let's try and, you know, see what sort of, how she would fare in front of a camera. With the actors maybe 20 or 30 years ago, appearance wasn't so much of a issue. It was more of the character and personality. These days, a lot of the male actors, heroes, you'd find that have come from the modelling world, and they are expected to have a good physique.
I was watching a film not too long ago. It was one of the old ones from 2000, but was in it, and he was on the beach, but like his body was like flabby. It wasn't bad, but there was no six pack. There was just, you know, like a normal.
Yeah, even in Kamikushi Kamigam, she's wearing all those like crop tops, but she hasn't got like a six pack or a flat.
Yeah, whereas like fast forward 14 years, yeah, and they've got six packs and toned bodies. So it's that they've developed in terms of the sex appeal area.
A lot of the children in next generation in Britain today are very much into Bollywood. Even their English or other ethnic friends are into Bollywood, whether it be through the dance, music, fashion.
Bollywood is trying to modernize, and there's like kind of two directions they can go. You can kind of go in the really cheesy, tacky, but sex appeal kind of.
Yeah.
Or you can go into the kind of historical, real.
Like real life, dealing with issues, kind of way.
I think that's where Bollywood's kind of headed. Yeah, I can definitely see Bollywood taking over Hollywood one day. The reason being is recently there's been a lot of collaboration between a lot of other ethnic cultures coming into Bollywood movies. For example, within the last 10 years, you've had things like Mistress of Spices, which involved an English actor as the main hero and an Indian actress as the heroine.
Bollywood films are going to go long, it's not that, but it will probably revive again and back to its old, you know, values, hopefully. That's what my hope is. I hope that.